Hey guys, this is Amy with Stick With The Plan, and today we're talking about This Means War. Stay right here, we're gonna get right into it. Thanks for joining me today. We are here. This is Mark Hankins Ministries Properties. We're at their leadership conference this week. It's been awesome. And the message that's been stirring in my heart is this means war. Just a couple of days ago, a friend of mine was telling me that their baby was diagnosed with having signs of autism. And, you know, it broke my heart for them. You know, this friend of mine was very upset, so we began to pray. And in my heart, I just started thinking about, this means war. What do you do when you get a bad report? What do you do when you know the promises of God, but something contrary comes at you? I immediately thought of the book of Ephesians in chapter 6, where it says, you will not have to be strong in your own might, but be strong in the Lord in the power of His might, putting on the armor of God. So I just started asking, Lord, help us to know that we are armed in you. That when we go into battle, when we get a negative report, when we have lack or we need something, that we are well armed and well prepared for battle. So I'm praying about this, and I woke up just about 2 days ago. I haven't even got to tell my friend this vision that I saw, this dream about our family. I was in a room by myself at first, and then a door opened, and I saw her and her husband, and they were marching in, and I was just being prayerful, I remember. Well, I joined in the march, and I remember as I looked at their faces, they had like a note of victory. Their countenance was very pleasant, and one door came open, and they came marching in, and I got right in line with them. Like I was joining my faith with theirs. Another door opened in this room, and they went right back out, and we were just marching. It was like we were taking our ground, like we were gaining what belonged to us. We were advancing in our territory or taking back anything the enemy was trying to steal from us. So, I was just marching with them, and I remember I asked the Lord in my heart when I saw this vision, why are they so happy? And He said, they've got their armor on. They got their war clothes on, that they're ready for battle, is what I heard. Ready for battle. How can you be ready for battle? Well, we go on in that chapter and it talks about having the full armor of God on so you can stand against the enemy, the devil, in the evil days. Why? How can we do that? What is our armor? Well, I believe you have a helmet of salvation is what it tells us, a breastplate of righteousness. You're in right standing. We've got the shield of faith. That's our belief system, what we believe. You've got your feet shod with the preparation of peace. Your loins are girded with truth. We know the truth of the word. And I wanted to remind you of the sword of the Spirit. That is the word of God coming out of your mouth when you speak it. That should be our weapon of choice against the enemy. I thought about this, when thoughts come, when evil thoughts come, when negative reports come, you might be like my friends that got an evil report from the doctors, concerning your children. Maybe it's in your own body. Maybe it's an evil report against your finances. I've been in business. We understand what that's like when it looks like you're about to lose everything. What do you do? How do you fight when there's nothing naturally you can do? I believe that's when we take on this full armor, not strong in ourselves, but strong in the Lord. So you take out this sword of the Spirit. It is the written word. So when thoughts come, you start speaking. So, and when I saw in this vision, us marching around and taking back what belonged to us, this song was playing called This Means War. And even though this song talks about everything that's going on bad about you, you are just singing, all is well. You get out the scriptures, you start saying, hey, if God be for me, who could be against me? You just let yourself take on that whole armor of God. When those thoughts come, when negative reports start coming, you start speaking. This was Jesus's weapon of choice. When he was led out into the wilderness where he was tempted of the devil, he conquered him by saying, it is written. I'm saying this means war when the enemy comes against you, your family, your finances, your health, trying to steal your peace or joy. You remind him of that sword of the Spirit you have. You declare the word of God and say, it is well. God is for me. Who could be against me? And that's all you'll stick with the plans he has for you. Thanks for joining me today. We love hearing all the testimonies. Let us know how we can pray for you. And thank you for sharing this. We love reaching new people each week because you are sharing this. If you're on YouTube, hit that subscribe button. Leave us a comment. If you're on Facebook, like this page. We got a brand new video for you coming out next week. And remember, every Tuesday, we are live at 10. I'll see you then.